It's a beautiful day and welcome to Just Talks. By the way, my name is April together with
JP Malia
and Samantha Sawanan. Of course, nandito ngayon tayo, one of the legal counsel ng SB member po.
Ang lawyer, of course, ng Sangguniang Bayan, ang municipal councilor, Honorable
Manuel M. Lipardo Jr.
Kanay ba po, nag-chorus gid mo?
Yes!
Hi, good morning!
Ilang taon ka po ba na in love?
Wow, I cannot remember. I think when I was, I think, in grade 5.
And how's that girl?
Atras mo pala. I think in grade 1 pala. But I know she knew na she was my crush. Classmate ko ng grade 1 dito sa Manay. Yes, oh.
So, can you give us an overview or background about your educational?
As I've said, dito ako nag-kinder, grade 1, grade 2 dyan sa Central 2. And then grade 3 and onwards to 6, nilipat ako sa Davao, sa UIC. It used to be ICC, Immaculate Conception College. And later it became University of Immaculate Conception. And then in high school, I went to Holy Cross, yung sa Santa Ana. And then in college, I took up AB Political Science in Ateneo. After graduating, I took up Bachelor of Laws in the same school, Ateneo. I took the bar in 2006, and a year after, or 6 months after I took the bar, in April, I think 3 of 2007, I became a lawyer. 2007 until now, I'm practicing as a lawyer. Yeah. I had a girlfriend in College of Law na, to cut the story short, nagkaroon kami ng anak. No? But for one reason or another, hindi kami nagkatuluyan. And so, after I took the bar, my father was really very supportive of me. But pag humana kong take og bar, giingnan ko niya nga, "Do, human naman akong obligasyon ni mo, kasay-kasay na diyang imuha." But at that time, because of the presence of that baby, by that time po, hiwalay na niya itong ako ang buwan. I had no other choice but to teach. I was teaching there while waiting for the result of the bar, no? Because I needed money. I needed to support that child. And then my father already told me that you're already on your own because you already fended for you. So I took it by heart, and that's how we were raised and trained. Kami nga mga magsuon, you really have to find what is yours. Ended up teaching there, and then at the same time, I went to the law office of my former boss, Attorney Roger Largo, a guy from Lupon. By the way, he is just recently appointed as Justice of the Court of Appeals. Ha? So, Brad Roger, makita nimo, congratulations. I ended up also as a trainee there sa opisina niya, handling legal documents while waiting for the bar. So, with that, moti akong gitarbaho while waiting for the bar. But the prime mover there for me is para ma-sustain ako ang pangilanganan atong ako ang bata. After passing the bar, na tumnan pod nga doon na may Brad pod nga doon na yung father-in-law nga taga Cotabato, kini mga sinswat. And so I ended up lawyering for Ampatuan and Sinswat there. But our boss, si Attorney Largo, may nagdasa mo dito. So for 2007, ang first bang didayon sa amo as lawyer is being an election lawyer there. There are a lot of memories there. Pero tigil. Ambot o kaya pa ba na ako buhatan taro ni na siguro. Like, it will really place your life in danger yun yung mga type of alcohol. So after there, in 2007 also late, I decided kinahanglan ko mubalhin sa Manay kay by that time, si Papa was diagnosed with lung cancer. and stage 3 na siya, late stage 3. So I could not imagine myself being told nga naapos Davao na practice, and then taugan ko sa kong mama ba o sa kaigsoon nga your dad is already about to pass out. O niya, mag-drive ko ba? Mote kong kahadlokan, basing maunsa. So I decided I have to be here in Manay. However, pagtanaw po na ko sa Manay, na si Attorney Lopez, at hindi man may mabuhi ni Attorney Lopez Duhara, may diri mag private. I was really in the private sector. So in the course of, di man makaya na to ang Manay kay gamay ra po klinte, I decided to stay in Mati. So when I was in Mati, I rented a very small place. I did not ask anything sa kumama. I did not ask anything sa upapa. At that time, I was really thinking also, I'm already a lawyer. Capable naman ko mangitag paningkamot na ko. Yeah. Si Papa, ginapatambalan. It even reached a point nga, ipamaligyan na mo ang properties Davao City. Really just to address kay medyo mahal magod ang iyahang kuan, ang iyahang patambal. So, and it's okay. Ano man yun na mo? Mukuan tagkabtangan kay kung kinahanglanon ato mabaligyan. So, I did, ended up practicing in Mati, and at the time I was connected with the Honorable Mayor Michelle Rabat as city legal niya, but prior to that gina-question man ang cityhood atus Mati, so more of consultant ko nila. At the time pod consultant na ko ni Boss Mayo, ang atong congressman sa district 2, Almario. So kana, and then in 2012, I was appointed already as city legal kay humanaman ang kaso ato sa Supreme Court sa Ligub City sa to, against the municipalities. So, kanto. Now, padayon, and then pagkapil din niya in 13, I went back to private practice again. But at the time, naanatay mga diskarte, mga naanatay mga ban-ban, nga mamabiyahe, naanatay internetan. Diskartis kinabuhi.
Ganyan na lang yan.
When did you get married?
When did I get married? 2007, September 8. Kanipong akong naminyuan, classmate ko niya o grade 4 o grade 5 sa UIC.
Oh, iba din yung grade 1.
Uy, na ito sa Manay.
Cash lang. 4 and 5, grade 4 and 5.
Classmate na ko siya in 4 and 5. However, dili tong tipo nga ma-crush nimo. But in 2000, I think 5, we had a reunion sa among batch sa UIC sa elementary. Unya, ang iya hamanggong manghod si Attorney Karin, the wife of Judge Manluyang, no? Was also in law school. Siya ang naghatag sa siya ang nagpabaw kay Kathy, is my wife, nga nakita ko niya sa law school pod. At that time, si Kathy, I think, na ako'y kabatch nga nagapanligaw sa iyaha. Katong naligaw sa iyaha, may gipangayuan niya sa akong number. Niya, gikontak ko niya nga. Niya, kuya, papagakontak ang mga cellphone sa una, dili pa man Android. Good. Uy, ano pa? Uy, Manuel, na atay kuan kanang reunion. Okay, sa mani si Kathy kaa, sige, doon naman good po may kabatch nga barkada kay nako nga ako po'y makakontak sa iya. So there, pag reunion, matay pagkakita na kong Kathy, hasta mabaga naman eh.
Oh, ba? Ang feelings.
Ay, wala pa may feel. Dito na develop.
Pero yung tanong, paano mo, in what way, or anong moves mo pa siya na pa-yes?
The usual. Giving of flowers, ligaw. Pero, I thought all the while na siya boyfriend, no? Okay. During that night, I think we were in Garden Oasis, katong amuang kuan, amuang reunion. And then after there, we went to the venue yata. Sa Garden Oasis pa lang pagpanguli, I thought ako'y makahatod sa iyaha ba. But I saw somebody fetching her, sundo sa iyaha. Pugi kayo. Disoy kayo. Text na ko siya. Ah, may boyfriend ka na pala. So, wala man. Siya, may magsundo pala sa iyo. Siyempre. Kaya kung nauna, wala lagi boyfriend, pero basing naligaw po na. Klaro na kayo, bisan pag matay, bisan pag piyungan to, wag yung ko'y kaya at do. All the while, iya din brother, si Dennis, mag-uwang nila. Puging man itong buwan ito. Yati so, itang katrukuhon, liwat ni tatay po na. Paingon niya nga, akong kuya, yun ako, ah, okay, ah, sige. Okay, hindi.
Sir, si Ma'am Kathy ba ang tipo ng babae na hindi, tawag nito, madaling pauuhin?
Si Kathy, she should find you first. Siyempre, at to her perspective, attractive. And then, kaya kung dali ito pa uuhon, nabi, nandigo siya at the time, ha?
Yes.
So, kana, siguro po, ambot na tayo, gani ko, hanto doon, kasi nakita niya sa kuwa.
Ilang so, taon na yung mga anak niyo ngayon, sir?
Eliza, 2008 until 11, no? 2000, ano? Si Eliza is already 13, go 14 na.
14.
Kasi February man siya. 2008, tama ba? 2022 ngayon, 14. 30, mag 11 siya ngayon, mag 12 by March 28, I think. And then si Liz, yung bunso, 10 years old.
As a lawyer, paano mo ba? How do you discipline your children?
Wow. The only way I can imagine on how to discipline them is how I was disciplined by my father and my mother. Ang akong papagmama is a combination of a carrot and stick. Kanang paulian ka o niya, piktosan ka sa isa, o kanang tawag lang good cup, bad cup. Really, kabaw man po ka, ayaw akong mama iniba, ayaw kalain ma, o makita niya. Kuan yun akong mama, really very disciplinarian. Because that was how she was raised by her mother also. And her father, si Lolo Istong. Akong papa is the type nga dili mangunal, dili mangunsa, pero makaistorya sakit po kayo. Between the two, mas masakitan ko adtong sa akong papa. Kay siyempre, dali man may ikot. Siya mong mama, bunal, the wound will just heal and then you will not feel anything po na ng kuhan na kay mama mani mo. But in the eyes na mong magsuon, si mama dito itong mamang disciplinarian. Si Papa is more of maragkulang to siya. Dili to siya ganahan o ka ng bugat ng adlaw. Gusto ito niya ganang jolly lang, ano lang.
Smile. How will you manage your time as a public servant to your family?
Wow. You simply have to find time. Because I'll add more there. Family, you're being public official and ang imo pong panginabuhian. You simply have to find time. Kay ug dili, you will be swallowed. If we speak of being a public official here, kabaw magitag sa mga tungdanan, wa magigit kaundangan ng panginahanglan ng tao, di ba? So, if you decide ihatag na lang nimo imong tanang oras dere, mahugpod nga, wad ang kag-oras sa imong pamilya. You really have to manage it. Time management for this multitask ang importante lang. And kana gid when I'm with my family, I really make sure na quality time yun permitting. Okay, not all the time andyan mag-urban.
Can you give us an overview about your committee?
Committee, well, I'm handling the committee on tourism, education, of course, ordinances and laws. And then the rules, apat. For tourism, it's very unfortunate because of the lockdowns now. But what we are looking at are somewhat laying the foundation on how can we sell our town as a tourism town. Like before you can do it, you have to prepare the ground. The accommodations must be there, and of course the sites must be well supported. Kay nabaw man ta, our town really is the tourism here is from ridge to reef. The ridge we have is we start in Kampalili. Pagkanaog na to ana, hastang daghan na pa na apaning kan Judge Nonot in Panungtungan. And I don't know if you've heard na aning murag botanist nga setting like in Holy Cross, taas katagbakan.
Yes.
And then we really have plenty of falls, ate mga falls na more gining true nga falls. And then we have lakes. Of course you've heard of Jumabuk Lake. You've heard of the three lakes in Rizal, no? Kanang naa diha sa bayanihan. And we have caves. And then sa atong reef, ang atong reef is buhi kayong atong mga kuan padiri, corals. Tay white sand nga naa sa San Ignacio. Diri na atay diri sa kuan pod sa Manay. And then this one, so tourism kani ang ato ang hopefully in kung tugtan ta nga makabalik my next term, really I would also get this committee still and then really pound on this one. Sa education, well, actually there is no committee karon nga wa nagkalisod because of the pandemic, but we try to make do kung unsay naa. So far we have converted I'm not sure as to the number, but a handful kaning mga elementary schools na to nga i-convert nanto into an integrated school where they can accommodate grade 7, grade 8 later on. And then one particular school nga ato ang gipaningkamutan pod karon, and this is with the help of course ang mover gid ini are the family of Dimandabons, no? Ang nag-donate sa yuta si Mano Roger Mandabon, but the prime mover here is si Sir Erwin Kasagda.
Ah, okay. Tag.
Yeah.
Si
Teacher Erwin. And then, ang kuan, ang locality nila sa Sitio Kapok sa Rizal. So, that is an establishment of elementary school. Early in my term also, kani sa atong education, I already passed a resolution requesting the Davao Oriental State College to put up a satellite school here.
Wow.
an annex wow. Here at the time I had a huddle with the late mayor Manolo Dayang Hirang. He agreed nga maghatag og 1 hectare, and so I after that I started convincing him nga 1 hectare is not enough ground for a state college, and so he decided, di ba na atay gipalit nga 5 hectares dito sa taas sa Magson, ang tapad ato nga 5 hectares paliton pod so that he will be able to donate 2 hectares sa ato ang for the extension campus ni Durso. This I would say also has the backing kay nagapatabang po ko kay Ma'am Thelma Almario Duff, the former congresswoman of District 2. Eh, kabaw mong gitang tanan nga siya man po yun ang author, the creation of DOSCST. Nagpa-university lang karon si Sir Mayo. So, with that, naapod sila ay kanang pwedeng makahangyo po sila sa president nato diha nga. But I think the president now is si Sir Roy Ponce. And if you try, I'm really observing him. If you try to look at him, he is an advocate. So, dili lisod ibaligya nato ang atong plea nganhi nga in Davao Oriental they have established so much extensions in District 2.
Correct.
Doon na sila sa Lupon, I think. Doon na sila sa San Isidro.
Yes.
Banay-Banay.
Or even Katigan.
That's in District 1.
Okay.
Although ang GGCAST ilaong tanggi appeal mahimo sa university, unfortunately. But you can see there are 4 towns, 1 city, and they have main campus in the city and they have 4 extension campus in 3 towns. In District 1, we have 6 towns and yet we only have 1 extension campus. And it's in mainit katiil, it's not even in proper katiil. So, I know that kung si Sir Roy makita niya ni Heiser, we know that this will really be one of the legacies that you can do for the college and for our town by establishing an extension campus. Kaya di ba naanay gibutang untari sa unang private school?
Yes.
However, we know how hard it is now sending to school sa kadaghanan nato. So, the only way for us to go about it is government should be there. And State College is a government university. So, kana. Unfortunately, because of the pandemic again, here we go. So, if allowed on a second term, this will be my priority in the education. Really go for the, will push really for the establishment of an extension campus. Now, kung dili makuha ang 2 hectares nga yuta nga pwedeng ma-donate sa LGU padung for the area to establish the extension campus. Well, this might be a medyo layo nga panaghuna-huna nako, but if really dili mohatag si LGU, then I'm committed also to buy a property for this one. I-donate na to ni. Really, you know how it can really help our town. Try to imagine yourself, you're from Taukanga, or you're from Macopa, or you're from San Fermin. Pag subod sa face-to-face, pag eskwela, ang imong hunahunaon, ang puyan sa imong bata na tusmati, ang iyang allowance. Wala na nato i-appeal, that includes the food, the fare, and everything. Wala na nato i-appeal ang peril, ang danger nga ihansod na dito. Because, you know, I can really understand kay as early as grade 3, we were already sent away by our parents. Kay tungod naman lang panginabuhi ang maestro man akong papang mama. So I knew by heart kung unsa gyud ang kahimtang sa usa ka estudyante nga layo. So no one will tell you what to do there except yourself or maybe your kuya or somebody nga. So if you decide nga tambay-tambay lang barkada-barkada ka. So the peril, the danger is always there. But there are students also nga motivated, driven. Akanin, bisag unsaon ni maning kamot na sila. But try to imagine placing the school ngan his manay. If you are from Taukanga, you can even decide, pag lusot anang simintong karsada, 15 minutes na nagu ka sa Rizal. You can even decide every day imong ihatod o kuwaon imong bata. Di nakakinahanglan mo arkila ubay ang pagkaon, ang budget nimo dito na sa inyo. Plus the economic activity that it will bring to our town. Kung naay campus diha, most likely daghan po dihag mga businesses nga mo mushroom, no? Daghan kay na gikan sa kananan, paingon sa tinda-tindahan, photocopiers, everything, no? Bawal lang ng mga kuan, mga imnanan, palayo lang gamay palayo. So these things really has benefit for our town, and I would really hope if given the second chance, the second term, I mean, if elected here, this one I would really pound on this one, establishment of a. So kana in ordinances, I cannot memorize how many ordinances we passed.
Actually, talking about ordinances, so kahit even as nahililito pa kami confusing about those words. Of course, ordinances.
Ordinances are local laws. When you say ordinance, I'm sorry. When you say ordinance is a local law that operates within our own locality.
Yes.
So, pasabot, maunay sundos to mga tao dire. Pero we are guided as local legislators to make local laws that does not contravene the provincial laws and the national law. So dapat ang among buhaton nga balaod diri haom sa kung unsa nay existing nato sa provincial o sa national. Pero kung pananglitan wa pay balaod gipasa ang national o local and guided by our morals and policy dili siya illegal, we can make that local law specifically mo implement lang diri sa tua. One of the very basic local laws nga really for local are the curfew kana siya. Pwede na ito ng buhaton.
And how about resolution?
Resolution, technically, is a statement of sentiment. Statement of policy. Resolution, let's say when we give authority to the mayor to enter into contract, that's how we go about it. Resolution, when we say that we do not like what is happening, so we state our sentiment. These are the purpose of resolutions. Or let's say we wanted to make the national hear us on what are our pleas, pwede na ito na i-resolution sa lahat. Address to the president, address to the senator, address to the congresswoman, address to the governor, kaya sa resolution ng atong ginabuhatan.
And of course, give us some more idea about supplemental budget.
Wow! Anong supplemental naman ka diretso? Budget talaga ginta. Supplemental, supplemental budget is what you do when you have an amount that is not that is free from any determination or allocation. For example, savings. There can be a supplemental budget for savings. But supplemental budget actually should not be abused. Kay sa mga kanang mga antigo kay sa financing, before ninyong ipasa ang inyong total budget, municipal budget, it should be carefully thought of, well planned. Then you should make sure that it will really cover everything kung makaya, as far as human capability can. Kung naay di makita, most likely that will be somewhere in the third quarter, that's July, August, September, or baba pa. That's when you go supplemental na. Tao lang magunta ko, nakita na to, nga problema. Ah, sige, natay savings, supplemental na to. So, most likely, supplement from the word itself, it only supply an addition. But the mother there is really the budget by itself, the municipal budget.
Ano siya? And how about general fund?
Wow, general fund. General fund is general fund. Paano ba yan?
General
fund allocation is, I don't know how it
that's
is.
That's coming from national
work. Ah, okay. You're referring to the IRA. It's no longer IRA. Internal Revenue Allotment is no longer IRA. It's already NTA, National Tax Allocation. National Tax Allocation is the fund coming from the national government because of what is authorized by the Constitution. So, yearly, kaning collection sa itong BIR o sa ato ang, including now because of the Mandanas case, ang ato ang Bureau of Customs, ginalamp na siya tanan. And then for LGUs, there is a certain percentage there. And then later, ihatag na siya. Depende kung unsa kang class po. Depende po kung province baka o city baka o municipality ka.
So how about the Annual Investment Program or AIP, sir?
AIP, wow. Mudugo na nga itong dunggan sa listener M. AIP is a collective mas keen on looking on specific na ang annual investment program na to, which is a derivative of the, I think, the local development plan. No, ang local development plan na to, LDP, usually term-based na siya. I think it's 6 years. So we were informed nga ang atong LDP is from 2017 until 2023. That's why we're about to do again the local development plan. So annual investment plan, that is where you see where all of the money of the government, the LGU, manay, for purposes that it has a allocation for it, dito niya gina-invest. Makita ni muna dito sa iyang annual investment program. What are the priorities really of the mayor? And then after ana, would come the budget by itself. Pag budget ana, i-allocate na dito sa ato ang budget officer. But of course, these are all guided by the mayor because this is the mayor's budget as well as the executive budget. After ana, ipasa na sa itong sanggunian bayan. And sanggunian bayan would try to scrutinize it, whether or not there is a basis for the budget to be there, or whether or not kinahanglan ba the budget stays or the budget will be slashed. Depende na nasa.
That's what's the reason of ELA and how important is it?
ELA is very important. Executive Legislative Agenda is a principle in governance that should not be taken for granted. Because it is where you fuse the intentions of the executive as well as the legislative branch. When you have your ELA, we are told that after the approval of the ELA and there will be covenants there, means signing, kini nga ELA, mao dapat ning atong budgetan. So, really is very important because regardless of color in politics you are in, ang concept there is ELA is one of those that will shield the people from the effects of the different colors in politics. Kay kining ELA, mauna ni katumurag na abtans mga panghuna-huna sa atong mayor, sa atong vice mayor, sa atong konsehal, nga nganhi atong priority gyud. So, regardless kung asa kagikan, magikan ba ka sa admin, magikan ka sa opposition, or what party you belong, kaning ELA importante gyud ni sa. As I've already said time and again, there should be weight on ELA because we should always learn that being public official elected at that, we don't serve our purpose. We don't serve our personal interest, our personal purpose. We serve the interest of the governed, the many. So, that's why ELA, importante gid kay na siya.
Usually, how long will it take for the ELA to be approved?
Wow. Ang ELA is term-based po na. 3 years na siya. So, it takes really an ample time. 1 year maybe. So, you see how tedious it is for you to come up with that document. So, no amount of any politics should disrupt the operation of the concept of ELA. Bahala kung sige kapaingnan sa inyong politika, pero katugi dapat kay ang kapaingnan mangudana, really it will benefit everyone.
So dapat maganda ang relasyon.
Yes, of course. It should be. Kasi at least that is what the people wants from us.
Correct.
Yes.
Correct. 20% development fund.
20% development fund. From the word itself, development, it is focused on projects, developments in our town. For this year, our 20% development fund is somewhere around 53 million for our town.
Per town?
Now, no, in Manay. In Manay. And the previous years, nag-acquire tagdagag heavy equipment eh. The purpose of the heavy equipment, makita na to, kanagasigig dagandagan. No? And then, really the purpose is para ma-address nato ang common nga problem nato, problema dong karsada, problema dong these things.
About DTP, the devolution transition.
Wow. Where did you get your terms? Devolution transition plan is a plan born out as an effect of the Mandanas case. Mandanas is Governor Mandanas, I think, of Laguna. I-question niya nga nung ang bahin sa LGU sa ERA or NTA na karon gamay lang. He won. And the decision of the Supreme Court had the effect of musaka atong NTA. So, you imagine now we are in 206. But, last year, 206 million rata. But now, including our internally generated income, mamahimo na tang 283 million. So, these really are the effects of the Mandanas. Musaka ta in the next 3 years. So, because of that, ang gibuhat ni national government, nagpakanaog pod siya og mga function in the DSWD, agriculture, and health, nga LGU na. That is where your devolution transition plan should come in. Now, kaning devolution transition plan, considering mao man ay maka ayo sa tibuok munisipyo na to on how to handle the increase because of the Mandanas effect, dapat ang tanan ani stakeholders apilon sa pagbuhat aning devolution transition plan. However, I think you already made also your research. we really do not know, the Sangguniang Bayan was not invited in the transition committee in coming up with the devolution transition plan for the municipality of Manay. So, sige lang, naramanggit siguro na usahay maimbitahan, usahay dili. So, what the Sangguniang Bayan did was, we invited, kung kinsa tong kabaw mo explain sa mua, unsa ang DTP. So, Sir Ryan of DILG came and explained to us, and then thereafter, kabaw na mi, in the DTP, ang MSWD na added function. So, dapat dito ang mong tanaw ng mga budget na madugang. Si agriculture, maura gihapon. Si health, maura gihapon. So, it's really like helping us. But it's sad to say, ang nakatabang sa mo sa DILG, supposedly, tak-in ming tanan because we're just one town. Auban dapat na to ang atong executive, which is headed by the mayor, the department heads, and the Sangguniang Bayan, and the capitans. But we were left out. Wala ming apila.
Tawag nito, mga issues sa social media.
So, yes. Okay. Yes.
Paano po ninyo ito na-overcome?
Well, you know, I really don't know, but I always see myself as, I am not really a true politician. So, I do with what I feel and what I think is right. And some of those that are said in the social media are purely a lie. Bakak ng langit. Pero, I really don't have time in trying to defend the Sangguniang Bayan or myself over these things. Because I think my time is worthwhile in doing more. Kung unsay makaayo, unsay pwede natong mabuhat. Kining mga istorya about sa Sangguniang Bayan. We're even called Sangguniang ng mga buaya. Magbuhi gyud kog buaya po na ako ipapaak ang buayahan na. No, because you know, we might differ this akong mensahe ni sa atong tanan, no? Including our politicians here. We might hate ourselves or the other ones na dili nato kauban sa politics. But by God, pag-reserve po, kanang don't allow yourself to be destructive. Okay ra man ang constructive ang ato ang pagpuna. Okay na siya. But you will reach a point where you will malign, panghimakakan nimo ang usa ka tawo o ang usa ka politiko or much more ang usa ka institution. I tell you, I always believe in this one. I always believe in the term karma. What goes around comes around. It's just like a principle of mirroring. Kung sa imong gipakita, di ba, manamin ka ng buntag, yes. It is what it is, mao gyud na. So kung magpakita ka dihag di mao, mao pugyud na imo balik nimo. A thousandfold ba na siya. So, sorry. Guha pa lagi gihapon. Guha pa gihapon. So, kana, let us not just forget that at the end of the day, governance is not really about sikat or end. Governance should always be, have you done enough for the constituents that you are serving? And what is enough? The greatest good for the greatest number should always be the count. What is really best for most of us. Now, pride to me should not come in. A pride should always be there because I don't see a person nga wala po'y pride nga mabuhi ining kalibutan nga dapat iyang kaugalingon. Pero, don't ever allow pride to come in between governance. Kadaray ako maingon sa mga politiko. Dari. Sometimes, you simply have to make a sacrifice because you are there. You are a politician. And when you sacrifice, you don't actually sacrifice for yourself. You are making the sacrifice for the governed. Kani mga tao. Diba? So, I don't know. Kana lang akong appeal. For those who continuously throw garbage sa Sangguniang Bayan, kanira po ako maingon sa inyo, ha? ang tanang panahon adunay kapaingnan, ang tanang ginabuhat nato adunay kapaingnan. Nya mag syempre magampo lang ta nga sa atong binuhatan nga dili mao di mo balik sa tua.
Bakit si Attorney Manuel Talapuan?
Well, bakit si Attorney? Because we have so much to do here. Maawa ka sa tao na halimbawa. And this is, to my mind, an issue about poverty. Plain simple, di nila marehistro ilang bata, di nila makuha ang birth certificate. Kaya nga no, wala man sila nakasal. Pero mali man ah. Di man ka pasabot kinahanglan kasado mo para makakuha ang birth certificate nimo. Pero sumpay po na sa kawad-on poverty. Ano magparehistro man ko dito nga mugasto kog ingon ini ingon ana. So I always call up the attention sa ato ang LCR. Ma'am, may buntag. Do na man gyud tay palisiya nga kung pobre ang magparehistro, libre gyud na tanan. Yes, of course.
Ma'am, please.
And ma'am, kung kaloyan ko, magpasa gyud kog ordinansa, i-exempt na nato na, di na gyud nato na pabayron. We need the data, basically ha. We need the data of pilay na anak. These data, it is not just needed in the national kinahanglan po nato na diri. And the effect later on, eh nani, di makagraduate o grade 6 kay kinahanglag birth certificate.
Yes.
Di maka-enroll kay kinahanglan. Dili maka... You will be surprised kung unsa kadaghan ni sila dere sa itong town. Now, if you go to a lawyer, a private lawyer, wag hanin nakaparehistro kay way kwarta. Matupag ang private lawyer para mo bayad. So, may bayad, ana. Ang pliti pa lang padong dito. Ang iyang pagkaon pa. Butang kog ang tuso niyang pagkaon. Nandito pa sa abogado. So, really, siguro sa gihatag sa ko ang blessing sa ng kanato taganla. Yang kanak pagkabugado, i kumbaga kamsan na magudi sa baknang oras mag-practice pa. But sugod ng idiak manay. Yang kanak pagkaabugado, ihatag ko isang dalang isab nang libre sang tao. Kaysa na panahon makatabang-tabang man kita. In 2019, ang akong mensahe would always be akong ihatag sa inyo ang akong pagkaabugado libre. No, my days as a counselor here in Manay nga di nako mapaningkamutan nga mabutang gyud nato ning extension campus sa State College
diri. Ayun sa
ana. We really need it. We badly need it. Kinahanglan jud kay na siya.
Mas maganda na para may last lang tayo pa mabilisan lang po, fast talk lang muna tayo.
Fast talk, okay. Wow.
San ka po dito? Summer or winter?
Summer, of course.
Beach or pool?
You have to be in the beach. I cannot imagine being in the pool.
Local or national?
Oh, of course, local.
Lastly, lights off, lights on?
Of course. I tell you, it should be a combination, silhouette.
Awesome.
To make it more romantic.
Anyway, thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for also the opportunity to be in your program. And at any time po, kung may kailangan tayo, even this one or anything, dito lang po ako palagi. Panghuli po, I'll have to say this one, because sa karon mang good, every Tuesday ko dire, maabtataw sa haitag alas city medyas gabi eh, bago makauli, unya ang mga tao mo, what good, no? Kinaagi, kinahalan nun. I'll try to arrange po my schedule. Kung makaya, kayahong ko ni, at least man lang Monday, Tuesday na ako dire. Pero kung kaya pa mo Wednesday ko, lampurnason ko na. Kaya arong, dili kay taas ang pilas tao. Arong, halos na yun everyday makita, makaanhay sila sa itong opisina.
So at this time, attorney, I would like to take this opportunity to say thank you in behalf of the LGBT. Kasi from the pandemic, from 2019, 20, napaka-present mo, parang yung binigay sa atin na ayuda ni attorney.
Yes, of course. Yes, words mo sa LGBT. And our words lang po para sa LGBT.
Wow, LGBT, you know, I see you guys are really as really unique. And being unique also means that your contribution to our community must also be there. And to me, it matters most kung not just with everyone but including the LGBT. Your voice should always be there. Kabaw man ko nga, haud kayo mo ang mga inanambutanga. LGBT is also like the sector of already of women, of kining, it's just also, it's now another sector. So, that means naagid may role po sa to ang community. Take care of it and be supportive of the government also. Because we really need all the voices that we can get, most especially sa ato sa LGBT. So, adya!
Yes, we will, because sige, we can.
Yes, of course.
And once again, thank you so much for watching to our Honorable Manuel Aimee Pardo Jr. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.